I missed you. Still not very explosion proof, I see. I'm here to fetch the lass. No, not you again. Yes! I missed him so much. Yes! So worth it. Why did you wrap her in a blanket? She's an avatar, she couldn't feel cold or anything like that. Shouldn't. She just looked like she needed this, alright? Stop nagging. Leah, my girl, you're back! Hi, poor thing. You're like you've been through hell. Hell no. You two, we'd like to talk to the lass in private. Hi, Captain. Sir, you've got some explaining to do. What in the bloody hell has been going on with you two? Ending up in that place somehow. Yes, it is about time I tell you everything I know. But first, let me apologize to you, Leah. I deceived you, telling you this lie about yourself and your past. Why? I just thought it would be for the best. When in all honesty, I did not know what to do. Why? It is because of what you are. Shizuka, she was right. You are an artificial intelligence. More precisely, you are what Satoshi liked to call an avatar. Let me start from the beginning. It all started several years ago. Finally some answers. At a time when we were all still employed by InstaDiamond, Satoshi, he was one of the head software engineers for Crossworlds. He was responsible for implementing the avatar control engine. You see, since avatars are controlled with a mere thought, this part was one of the most complex and difficult to get right. Yet Satoshi succeeded in creating a reliable connection. He developed a neural network analysis, a neural network analyzing the player's neural oscillation. After just a short learning phase, it allowed for controlling your avatar like it was your own body. It was a technological masterpiece called the CrossCode. After some time though, Satoshi discovered something new. The CrossCode went beyond just analyzing players' thoughts to control avatars. Using the same neural network as a foundation, it was possible to entirely simulate features of the brain. Perception, logical thinking, emotions, even memories. Before you knew it, the CrossCode evolved into a fully fledged AI, and it could run an avatar, without the player, a so-called avatar. So yes, that is what you are, Leah, an avatar based on Shizuka. Your personality and memories are a copy of hers. And that is also why I did not want to tell you the truth. Back in the day, Satoshi discovered that avatars had problems handling the truth about themselves. To have the memories of your human self and discovering that you are in fact an AI. It is a massive emotional shock that the system usually could not handle, leading to permanent malfunction. Fortunately, that did not happen to you. It seems you accepted the truth. Again, I am sorry for all of this. Things might have been easier if I told you right away, but it could have been an early end to everything. I just could not know what would happen, so I tried to be careful to minimize the risk. So, wait, did you actually tell her the coma story? Yes? Seriously, I told you that one would be too dramatic. It was the most logical option to... Really now? Did I understand that right, sir? These are dirtiest avatars in Crossworlds, and they copy the personality and memories of players. That is the other thing. There really should not be any avatars in Crossworlds at all. Satoshi was very excited by his discovery. He pitched his findings to the higher-ups, hoping to develop a fully autonomous AI based on the CrossCode. However, InstaDiamond was far less enthusiastic about it. Their priorities were clear, it was only about controlling avatars. Any additional functionality, especially the copying of memories, was unwanted. The they immediately blocked any effort going into developing avatars. Satoshi, he was deeply frustrated about this. Soon afterwards, Satoshi, Shizuka, and Gautam, all three of them, left the company. All I know is that they found someone that supported their continued research on avatars. They even wanted me to join them, but I declined. The whole endeavor, it seemed very risky to me. Anyway, it was not long afterwards that I entirely lost contact with them. I had not heard from them for years. That was until recently, when I discovered Lia, hidden within the game's database. And that is how the whole thing started. I took some time off from work and locked Lia into the game, looking for answers.
I know as much.
So how did you end up in that place? Well, that is where things started to become strange. We were pulled into an area that was not supposed to be part of the official playground, Vermilion Wasteland. Gautam and Shizuka, they were both there. And then there was this masked person we saw on the last day. But Satoshi, he was nowhere to be found. We were close, really close to answers. Yet we could not afford to stay there, it was too dangerous.
How come?
Somebody with administrative access to that area was tracking my connection. They tried to locate me, and almost succeeded. I just barely escaped it by minimizing communication with Lia over the last few days. In the end, we just had to escape.
I see.
And that really is a lot to take in, you know? How about we take a little break? Lia, maybe a little stroller on the ship would help you to loosen up a bit? Surely that's no problem, right, Cap?
I sure don't like you deciding that by yourself. But sure, it's alright.
Great, then how about you show Lia around a bit?
Why am I now?
Please, I'd just like to have a little word with Sergio for a moment.
Fine, follow me, lass.
Carla, is something the matter? Mister, I got a question for you. Something the poor girl is probably worrying about.
Yes?
Once you find Satoshi and everything has been cleared up, what will happen to her? That is a good question, isn't it?
There, girl, ordering me around like that. I got a reminder who's in charge on this ship sometime. Yes, you really seem to be in low spirits, but I really have no time for strolling around right now.
Captain? Do you mind if I borrow Mrs. Avatar for a moment?
No, that'd be just perfect. Please, keep the lads busy.
Thanks, please come this way, Mrs. Avatar. I'm gonna serve myself something to drink because my throat and mouth and everything is really dry from all this talking. This is great. Never expected to see you on this ship again, Mrs. Avatar. Lia. Do you want me to call you by your first name? Sure. Anyway, I'll go ahead and get everyone together. Just meet me outside, down on the deck. Finally, we can do the experiment. Experiment? Huh? There's that guy again. Elevator. This way?
This way.
Hi. Thanks for calling, Miss Lia. I mean Lia. Hello, so the pseudo robot has actually returned. Please stop calling her that. She's an actual person with an enemy. Lia. Alright then, Lia. My colleague and I had a little discussion over how well instant mother-based avatars can handle water. To my knowledge, instant mother easily evaporates when in contact with water. That's why swimming was never an option with the technology, but he claims that it can actually withstand decent amounts of water. Right, yeah, I was totally fine when it started raining last time she was here. I saw it myself. Well, a bit of rain maybe, but let's see how she handles slightly larger amounts of water. How? Quite simple. Please stand at this point here for a moment.
Why?
No worries, you'll see. All right, we're ready! Sorry, they talked me into it.
Why?
Sorry, Leah. But you see, she did not evaporate. I have to admit I didn't expect this. But that was just a small bucket. Now let's try the larger one.
But please, just one more time. Do it for the science!
Alright, second bucket.
See? It couldn't handle the adamant.
Alright, I see. Do you know, it could just be a general safety measure in case avatars actually jump into weather. Maybe they can potentially take even more weather than that. That might be it, but we can't test now, can we? That's true. Anyway, my point stands that instant matter avatars are just way too fragile for most serious applications. Come on, not all applications require high weather resistance. If it were just that, did you ever try to lift her?
What? I never dared to do that.
I sort of expected that. That's why I invited someone to help us out. Hey, Isabel, could you come over here for a sec?
Hello!
Hi.
Oh, who is that?
Leah.
Hi, Leah. I like your horse.
Yeah, she's another guest on the ship currently. So, why would you have her involved?
To show you how ridiculously like instant matter is.
Isabel, would you be so kind as and lift the young lady for us?
Huh? Can I do that?
Of course you can. Show us how strong you are.
Okay. Whee! Hi! Wow! She is so light! Wait!
Oh boy, I wasn't aware of that. Now that should weigh an average of maybe 5 to 10 kilograms of force. Instant matter is extremely light and fragile. It's a trade-off for being quickly constructed.
Yeah, Leah, wait, wait, why? She's getting heavy now.
It's okay, you can put her down now.
I want to throw her. Why?
Sure, show us some muscle.
And go!
Ow.
Awesome! Ow! Again! Wait!
So you see, super light, low water resistance, and believe me, any kind of fail impact and it breaks down. Alright, I see what you mean. Still, instant matter does not have its applications outside. Does have its applications outside of games, doesn't it?
Why? Why?
Of course it has applications, but it will never replace good hard machinery and architecture. You can't build a house with instant matter and expect to live in it. It would break down easily.
Again!
It works for crosswords because everything running around the playground is based on instant matter or virtual. It's like a theme park made of styrofoam. I see.
I'm beat. Yeah, you run real fast.
Oh, so either Leah's player is in quite good shape or avatars are not bound to the player's stamina. It's the latter, you can run for as long as you want and won't get tired. Anyway, thanks a lot for everything, Leah. And sorry for all the weather and throwing. Please don't hate me. I just wanted to show him how awesome avatars are. Nice work then, you really showed him.
Was it really that bad for you?
Well, I'm relieved.
It was fun. I want to throw Leah again.
Come on, give her a little rest, okay?
Oh man. Okay, see you later.
Hey Leah, I see you're having fun with the crew. I will soon start preparing things to get you back into the playground. It will take a bit of time though. It's probably a good idea to lock you off in the meantime. Before that though, there is something we should talk about. Since you know the truth about yourself, you're probably feeling a great deal of uncertainty, correct? In particular about your future. I do not want to give you any false hope. Your current situation is problematic. The only place for avatars to exist is within crosswords without official permission. This will only last as long as we don't keep it secret for entertainment.
Mm.
This is something we have to change, Lee.
Mm?
This is our goal, to create a proper place for avatars. One where you do not have to hide your identity. Satoshi, he always envisioned a place like that, even back then. Finding him is just the first step towards our goal. With his help, we might find a way to get you there. Well then, should we call it a day?
Mm-hmm.
Good night, Lee.
Bye.
Well, that's reassuring. Hopefully. Gautam, why did this happen? She had assistance. Somebody interfered. Hacked the environment server. That was bound to happen. The odds were still highly stacked against them. Hmm. This is like the cargo ship all over again. Gautam. Oh, it's that. Gautam, you need to stop playing around. Hmm. Understood. For now, continue with the interrogation. We are behind schedule. Interrogation? There you go. Nightmares of my flat. It was just bound to happen. Come on, let's run away.
Are they running in front of us?
Leah! Nightmares are right. Leah, please run away. There is no point waiting for me. Oh, I did miss one item, I guess, but not much I can do about it. Good morning, Lee.
Hi.
I hope you rested well. Any new memories? I see. Well then, the preparations to go back to the official playground are all finished. We will have to leave using the teleporter down in the cargo hold. Remember the one where we started? Carla should be waiting there for you. Also, I did a few more preparations on my side.
How?
Well, I moved locations again.
Why?
Just making sure nobody will be able to locate me. I did the same after you completed the Fashion Temple. That is why we had to stay offline for a while longer, remember? Anyway, things should be less critical since we are out of Vermilion Wasteland. And again, they most likely still have a ways to track us in the official playground. Otherwise, they could not have dragged us out of the raid like that. I still wonder how exactly they managed to do that. Maybe they can read the traces we leave on the game servers. Or maybe it is something very simple, like somebody watching us in game. Well, it is all speculation at this point, but we should be careful and watch our surroundings, okay? Anyway, onwards to the teleporter. Basement. One moment, let me add a little shortcut for you.
Oh.
This will take you right to the teleporter where Carly is waiting.
How?
Yeah, that sure would have helped back then when we had to run through the whole cargo hold, correct? Unfortunately, I did not have the routine to spam these shortcuts ready back then. Fair enough. Landmark? Surprise! I managed to add a proper landmark on the cargo ship. That means from now on you can travel back to the cargo hold whenever you like. But better not to try to drag along other party members. You are the only player that can enter this place. Hey, tall girl.
Hi.
You look pretty well rested. I suppose are you talking through with you? About time, really. Just so you know, you have all our support. If you ever need a break from that busy playground, feel free to drop by. Well then, let's get you back among all those other players. We stand in the middle of the teleporter. Everything ready? Good luck over there, girl!
Bye!
Ah, Ah, things are looking brighter already. Here we are. You should now be able to travel to all landmarks within the playground again. Also, direct lines should work again. It's probably a good idea to say hello to your friends again. We have been missing for quite some time.
Hi.
Bonjour. So, suddenly you're back. It has been what, a week? Oh, we lost our words as always. Give me at the guild headquarters. I want to talk to you in person. She seemed angry.
Why?
Well, you disappeared in the middle of the raid, remember? It is probably a good idea to talk to her soon. Yeah, let's go there right away. Over here. Yeah. Maybe we could just tell her the truth. I mean, if we have. If we were able to even, anyway. On your. So, what happened? All I know is that you just left in the middle of the raid. We had to cancel the whole thing. We had such a good run. Then you've been missing for a whole week. Well, sort of. You have still been listed as online, but I couldn't contact you.
Why?
That's what I want to know. Someone told me that you might have blocked us from contacting you.
Then what was it?
Please, you have to tell me.
How?
I don't know. Just somehow. There's so many things I don't know about you, and I can't even properly ask you. It's so frustrating. Lord, I guess all that's left then is asking lots of questions. Why did you drop out of the raid? Was it a bug? Then what? Did you cancel the raid on purpose? Then what else is there? Hello! Huh? Yeah, you're back! Oui, she just showed up today. I'm currently trying to find out what exactly happened. Well, that will be hard to figure out with her speech limitation. I know, I'll just poke her with questions until I get a good picture. That sounds troublesome. Leah, where are you going? Oh, Leah? What? Is everything alright? What are you doing? Just what exactly happened to you after you left the raid?
Why?
Sacre bleu! What is wrong with you?
Why? How?
What was that? That came out of nowhere. I don't believe this. Has she gone crazy or something? Probably worse than that. Leah? That Lucas, he does not remember what happened, correct?
Why?
I kind of suspected as much. Sorry, I should have talked with you about it. That Lucas you met in Vermilion Wasteland, he was most likely another Evotar. In fact, I suspect that was the case for all players we saw back there. Do you not want to go back to them? I see. This situation is rather complicated. But I am sure they still mean well with you. Maybe give it a bit of time. I am sure you will be able to reconcile eventually. I suppose we should go to Gaia's Garden next. That is the next major area north of Autumn's Fall. Our goal is still to reach Sapphire Ridge, correct? I really should try to extend your vocabulary, at least a little bit more. It will be difficult, but I know a few words that might help you in situations like this. I will get on that while you make your way through Gaia's Garden, alright? Okay. Can I just... Oh, he's offline.
fair enough. Okay.
Quests?
Present stakes. Can I just go back to the guild? Maybe.
I guess I can't.
Okay. Yeah, I guess all we can really do is continue. Oh, so I did get every item. What was... When did I even... Oh, right, in the actual... Like, when we were sneaking around, that was the item. Yay! Okay, well, at least we can start moving forward finally. That was quite a bit of, you know, work. So yeah, I guess it's this way. Secrets! You tell us this way? Hey, that's the base. You will know how the platform is that I can do. I can, however, break those things. And those. This way. That was a bit close. Okay. Yay, progress! Besides just moving it out of the way. But regardless, what matters right now is we got this. Fruit pie! Yay! Also, nice. So, you know, that's some progress. Ooh, pretty. Well, here we are, Gaia's Garden. A lot of new enemy types here. Funny enough though, no bugs. Huh? You see, Emily will probably be fine by herself. Sorry, I should not have said that. No, you should have. You should. Yeah, can do that. Bunch of trading.